Hey there, cats and kitties. I am the Blues Man, Johnny Blues. With this video, discussing my thoughts on episode 5 of the anime series Shokugeki no Soma Sen no Sera Totsuki Resha Hen, or the Totsuki Train Arc, the second half of season 3 of Shokugeki no Soma. And there's not really a whole hell of a lot to say about this episode, as it's not done yet. This matchup, this examination between Akira Hayama and Soma, is going to be stretched to a third episode. And that was somewhat surprising to me, because I think it's been a while in watching this show that we've had any sort of matchup like that go two or more episodes. It actually took me back to when I was first watching the first season of this series, and the people, because I'm not familiar with the source material, the people who are more familiar with the manga and everything like that could probably more accurately predict how long they would stretch out a given Shokugeki match between two of these budding chefs in Totsuki Academy, things like that. And I was always just along for the ride, debuting it to myself for the first time, wondering, you know, how long a given match was going to last. And I think it's like two episodes ago now that Akira was debuted in season 3. So the fact that we still have another episode to go before his dish is actually judged, and we see what the culmination of this examination between he and Soma, you know, how this all shakes down, was a little bit surprising. But, you know, I enjoyed this episode all told. I'm not really disappointed that it's being stretched probably just to the beginning of the next episode, where we find how the other leg drops. And I can only assume then we will catch up with everyone else who's facing a member of the Elite 10 in this third round. But, you know, I had that little bit of nostalgia. We have a couple introductions in this episode that were interesting. Berta and Scylla, this little duo, like these two little girl twins or something like that. I'm not sure how old they are, but they were kind of doing that twin thing where they're finishing each other's sentences, but at the same time, they're kind of divisive when they're first introduced. You know, you have one of them sort of siding towards Soma, the other one's siding toward Akira, and then it takes the other one convincing the first one that, no, you know, the more handsome guy, the more erudite looking Akira, he's the guy we should side with, you know. And then the whole episode is kind of them bending their will, leaning back towards Soma with Soma's cooking prowess in the sort of cutlet that he produces out of the bear meat and everything like that. Of course, Dojima returns, and we're actually introduced to Alice's dad, Arina's uncle, which was really interesting to me. I'd been wondering if we would ever get to see more of their family, you know, that kind of thing. I know we saw Alice's mother, Arina's aunt, previously, I think in maybe season 2 or the early portion of season 3. And I'd actually, frankly, forgotten all about that until we saw her briefly in this episode as a sort of flashback reference. But yeah, being able to see Nikiri's father and how he's such the doting, you know, husband and father and everything. Like, if he were an older brother, it would have been a complete siscon, the way he's infatuated with the portraits, the pictures he carries of them both. And his big dilemma in life is, I just can't tell you which one is the cuter, which one is the better, you know? They're both so adorable. I love them both so much and everything. So it's going to be interesting to see his judgment, you know, the judgment call he makes at the end of all of this. The one major thing that this episode did answer, though, was very much picking up on the overhanging question I had. Since, you know, Akira had debuted, since we had seen that he was now a part of the Elite 10, part of Central and everything, and we find out that there was like a battle royale for the position that he ended up landing as the 9th seat. But was frankly, what had happened with he and June and their little research facility and everything like that. And much as I had kind of surmised, but I didn't know if we would actually get the answer in this season at all, Azami came in and sort of carried at the end of the stick, waved it in front of Akira's face and said, look, your facility is shutting down anyway, because that's part of what I'm doing here. I'm shutting everyone down. And unless you want to, you know, challenge me to a Shokugeki and try to preserve your little place, it's all said and done. All the research you've done, I've, you know, gotten my hands on it. I'm going to use that to bait you effectively to do what I want you to do. And at the end of the day, that was to partake in the Battle Royale and side with Central. So all along, you know, Akira, he's not really the son of a bitch I took him for at first, but wondering, you know, where is June? What happened to them? I had left open, you know, the door just enough for the speculation that, well, maybe he had his hand forced. And lo and behold, that was the case. Out of this, you know, Akira reaped his own sort of little facility, his little cooking facility. And if he played along with Izami, part of that bait and switch was you can bring Jun along. And basically that's why he did this. If it was just he on his own, maybe he would have given up. Maybe he would have tried to fight it, but he probably would have gotten ousted if he didn't conform to what Izami had outlined for Totsuki now with Central and everything. But he was thinking about not only himself, but more so Jun and their history. And knowing that was going to be jeopardized, knowing that would leave her out on the streets to fend for herself, all their research gone, destroyed by, you know, Izami and everything like that. It really made, as Kuga observed, Kuga's still around for some reason, you know. Yes, he did help Soma previously with the spices and all that kind of stuff, and you know, the berries and whatever like that that are being put into his cutlet that he makes in this matchup. But he's still around observing things, and he does make the observation. Well, that kind of makes, you know, Akira just a little more sympathetic. I kind of feel bad for him now, that rueful bastard Izami, and I agree with that. You know, I was feeling sympathetic toward Akira as well, now learning that, in fact, it was because of Azami's doing, his forcing Akira's hand, that this is where Akira now finds himself, you know. But still, out of the two of them, Akira and Soma, I'm still rooting for Soma with all of that in mind. I mean, you could tell me it's one or the other of them that's going to get ousted if they lose this match, and I'm going to be for Soma. I'm going to be backing him to the nth degree. You know, no offense to Akira fans out there. But, yeah, we're going to have to wait, as I say, to the next episode to see how this all shakes down. Let me know in the comments below if you're following my coverage of the series, if you're following the anime, without posting any spoilers from the source material. What is your, you know, prediction? What do you think? Who do you think is going to take the win in this particular examination, this matchup? And, you know, I can only assume that we're going to see all of the other characters who are going up against their other respective Elite 10 members and everything in this challenge. You know, they kind of said it in this episode. Not everybody is going to be moving on to the next echelon. And it's going to be interesting to see if the next episode delves more into that. It focuses more upon these other characters and such, because that was very much part of where we left off, not just this match between Soma and Akira. So yeah, until the next one, that'll be pretty much it for me on this video. Find you well, and I'll catch you all later. Peace.